Hi, I'm Dr. Mallory. You or someone you love has a central line, and it's important that you know what that is, how it's used, and what the risks are. In this video, I'll have a brief conversation with a patient who is scheduled to get a central line placed. I'll review what the lines are, how they're used, and the risks associated with them. Hi, Julie. I understand you're going to have a central catheter, and you have some questions about it.
Yeah, I do have some questions. Can you explain to me exactly what a central line is?
A central venous catheter, or central line, is a thin, flexible plastic tube that is placed into a large vein. Intravenous or IV medications, blood products, and other fluids can be given through the central line. There are a few different types of central lines, and all of them fall into two main categories. The first is an external catheter. One type of external catheter is surgically inserted into a large vein near the heart. The other end comes out from under the skin of the chest. Another type is a peripherally inserted central catheter, also called a PICC. This catheter is inserted into a vein in the arm and advanced into a large vein near the heart. For any of these catheters, the tube that sits outside of the body may branch into one, two, or three smaller tubes. We call these lumen. Each of these has a cap on the end, and medications are injected into the cap and go through it and into the catheter and directly into your veins. These lines can stay in for a month to several years, depending on the specific external line that is placed and on the needs of the patient.
Okay, so I understand what the external lines are. What are the second type of line?
Well, the second type of central line is surgically inserted completely under the skin. This is called an implanted port. This line is usually placed in the chest, but may sometimes be placed in the arm. One end of the thin tube is fed into a large vein, while the other leads to a small rubber dome, or port, just under the skin. When medications or fluids are given, a special needle, called a non-coring needle, is inserted through the skin into the port. When not in use, the needle can come out, leaving nothing visible outside the skin except a small bump.
Can you explain to me why central lines are needed?
The main reason is to allow doctors and nurses to give you medications, fluids, or blood products that cannot be given into a small vein in your arm or hand. Central lines last longer than other types of IVs and avoid the need for multiple needle sticks.
Can you use a central line to draw blood off as well for lab work?
Well, technically, a central line can be used to obtain blood samples. However, we really try not to. Each time a central line is used, there is a chance for infection to occur, and studies have shown that drawing blood from a central line particularly increases that risk. To minimize it, we will use a vein in your arm or hand to draw blood whenever possible.
Are there risks when you have a central line?
Well, like all healthcare procedures, there are risks to having a central line. The main risk is getting an infection in your line. Your healthcare team uses strict sterile technique when placing the lines to try and reduce this risk. Also, the team will always use strict cleaning procedures while using your line. It's also possible for a blood clot to form in or around your catheter. This may cause swelling in your arm or neck or a blockage in the catheter. Using a syringe, a small amount of fluid is flushed into the line daily or after it is used to decrease the risk of a clot forming. There are also risks related to placing the line. Some bleeding can occur at the site of insertion. Usually the bleeding is very minor. Additionally, a line placed in the chest could cause a collapsed lung. This can happen anytime when someone performs surgery on your chest. Finally, you will be having local or general anesthesia during the procedure to place the line. These medications can affect how you breathe, and to reduce that risk, your health team will monitor you very closely when they are placing the line.
It sounds like my healthcare team has a lot of things to know about central lines. What do I have to know as a patient?
Well, the most important thing you can do as a patient is to be familiar with how to care for a central line. As a patient, you are an important member of your healthcare team. If someone's using your line, don't be afraid to speak up if you see something that you are not used to or are unfamiliar with. You will receive written instructions for caring for your line at home, which includes when to call your healthcare provider. In general, if you have any questions or are having any problems with the line, don't hesitate to call.
Thanks, Dr. Mallory. I've learned a lot about central lines.
You're welcome. Thank you for choosing May Medical Center for your health care. I hope this has explained some of the basics of central lines. At May Medical Center, we are here to provide the best care possible for your line. If you have any questions, ask a member of your healthcare team. And remember, it's your line, and as a patient, you are an important member of that team. Thanks very much for your time.